Hello, Bishop Wooden here. It's good to talk to you today. And I want to read a passage of scripture to you right quick. In Proverbs chapter 31 and verse 8, it says, "Open thy mouth for the dumb in the cause of all such as are appointed to destruction." This is among this passage is a part of the instruction that King Lemuel, who was actually King Solomon, he was given these instructions by his mother. Among the things she told him to do, open thy mouth for the dumb in the cause of all, look at this, in the cause of all such as are appointed to destruction. At least 4,000 times on average per day in this country, there are those who cannot speak for themselves appointed to destruction. Yes, I'm talking about abortion. And tonight I have a special guest who is going to be here at the Upper Room. And I want all of the members, I want all of the saints, I want all of our well-wishers, I want all right-thinking Christians and Americans to come and hear Dr. Evangelist Alveda King. Yes, Evangelist Alveda King. She works toward her purpose to glorify God in the battle for life. Just reading a little bit of her bio, she currently serves as pastoral associate and director of the Civil Rights for the Unborn, the African American Outreach for Priests for Life and Gospel of Life Ministries. She is also a voice for the Silent No More Awareness Campaign. This woman of God is a powerful woman of God who is fighting the good fight of faith. She's the daughter of the late civil rights activist, Reverend A.D. King, and his wife, Naomi Barbara King, and she is the niece to Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. This woman of God, I'm telling you, you want to hear her. I feel privileged that she would set foot in our church to minister and to speak to us. And what makes her such a dynamic person is her cause. She is continuing the civil rights struggle by fighting for the unborn. Evangelist King is a former professor, college professor, and served at Georgia State, served in the Georgia State House of Representatives. She is a recipient of the Life Prize Award 2011, the Cardinal John O'Connor Pro-Life Hall of Fame Award. I mean, she has numerous awards, and she is a best-selling author. Among her books are King Rules, 10 Truths for You, Your Family, and Our Nation to Prosper. How can the dream survive if we murder our children? And I don't want your man, I want my own. She is an awesome woman of God. The Lord has raised her up, and I want you to come tonight and to hear her here at the Upper Room Church of God in Christ. I will be here. We're excited about the service, and we are going to continue this fight. I want to say to all of those who believe that Black Lives Matter, in terms of the Black Lives Matter movement, I wish that the movement would show up in the one place where Black lives count in terms of dollars and cents, but they don't matter, because at these abortion clinics, you should see, my friends, the slaughter of the unborn as we walk, as our women, escorted in most cases by our men, their boyfriends, their lovers, their dads, their mothers, their grandparents. And listen, in case you think that this is a women's issue, statistics show that 81% of the time, 81% of the time, if the brother would just support the baby, the sister would give birth to the child. Oh, my friend, we have work to do. We have work to do. There can be no civil rights struggle. There can be no struggle. There can be no struggle for our nation. There can be no struggle if we are not allowed to be born. And today, now listen to me, Today, blacks are not giving birth at replacement levels. Genocide is taking place. And this woman of God is on the front lines fighting. Now, if you're watching this and you've had an abortion, listen, the Lord has forgiven you. In Mrs. King's bio here, she speaks of the abortions that she's had and how the Lord forgave her and set her free. She doesn't hide that. So we're not trying to bash anybody or remind you of some painful episode in your past that you repented for, that God has forgiven you for. Walk in your forgiveness. But here's what we need. We need you to join us. Join the movement to save the next baby. Oh my, please come tonight. I beseech you, to use a biblical word. That is, I beg you, come and hear this woman of God. You'll be glad that you did. And perhaps a little heart will keep beating and a little baby will live because of your efforts. God bless you. We will see you here tonight.